Hi friends, welcome to the session Hydrology and Irrigation. In this session, we are going to learn what is meant by hydrology and what is irrigation for the purpose of Public Works Department examination. So what is the depth needed for that exam? To that extent, we will learn this subject. Now, hydrology, what is meant by hydrology? Hydrology is nothing but the study of occurrence, circulation, and distribution of distribution of water on earth's surface. So this is nothing but hydrology. Let us understand in detail. So what is meant by this definition? Actually, study of occurrence, how the water is occurring. Generally, water can occur in any phase. It can occur in the form of solid, it can occur in the form of liquid, it can occur in the form of a gas, isn't it? If you look at the glaciers, it is a solid form of water. If you look at the ocean and rivers, it is liquid form of water. If you look at the clouds, it is a vaporized form of water. So the water is occurring in any of these three phases. So in what phase it is actually occurring? That is nothing but occurrence. Occurrence, and whenever in these phases, it moves from one phase to other phase. That means solid will move and become liquid because of the rising temperature, and the liquid will move and become gas due to further rise of temperature. So here, if you understand, the circulation of the water is happening because of the rise of temperature. Who is raising this temperature? Who is driving this hydrological cycle or this hydrology, water moving from one phase to another phase? That is the solar energy or solar radiation. So circulation is nothing but the circulation of a solid to liquid, and this liquid will become gas, and this gas again become liquid, and this liquid will become solid. So this is nothing but a circulation of water. So occurrence and circulation and distribution in the globe, how this water is being distributed. So the solid part is distributed on the ice caps like poles, whereas the liquid form, it is distributed all along the equator part. So likewise, how this distribution is happening? And the gaseous part is distributed all along the environment, atmosphere. So how the distribution of water is taking place? All these things, the study of the occurrence, circulation and the distribution all together is called a study of hydrology. Now, what is meant by hydrological cycle? Hydrological cycle. See, the hydrological cycle, I have already told you, this cycle is driven by solar radiation. So whatever be the radiation which is coming onto the earth surface, so it falls on the ocean. For example, this is the ocean. Now from ocean, what happens? The water will get evaporates. And it will become clouds. it will become clouds. It will become clouds. So some part of the clouds may stay here, some part of the clouds may stay here, and some part of the clouds may move from the place of origin. Okay, from here, some amount of clouds may stay here, and some amount of cloud may go somewhere. So whenever the temperature decreases, the water, the precipitation, so the whatever the vapor will become again liquid in the form of precipitation. So it forms precipitation, either it may form the precipitation on the ocean, or else it may form precipitation on the ground. So now when the precipitation is occurring on the ground, now the water which is falling onto this ground will flow like this. Now the water is flowing like this. Now some amount of water, whatever the water coming as a precipitation, it will flow like this, or it may flow into the earth's crust, or some amount of water may go back into the atmosphere. Whatever the water which is traveling along the ground surface is called runoff. It is called a runoff. Whatever the water going into the earth's crust, this is earth's crust. Whatever the water which is moving into the earth's crust is called infiltration. It is called infiltration. And whatever the water which is moving up, so some amount of water will go back like evaporation. See, again the evaporated water will again form clouds. So it again forms precipitation. This is a cyclic process. So now here, whenever there is precipitation, it forms runoff. Again, this runoff causes evaporation. This evaporation condenses. And it forms precipitation. So everything happens like this in a form of a cycle. This cycle is driven by sun. So it is a solar driven process. Okay. So generally we assume that the cycle is starting at oceans, because once the evaporation does not happen, this hydrological cycle will not get its ignition. So now we assume that it starts from the ocean, but it keeps on rotating, circulating like this. This is the brief understanding of the hydrological cycle. Now, what is meant by residence time? See, residence time is nothing but how much time the water is present in a particular phase in a hydrological cycle. If you see this here, this is gaseous phase, this is liquid phase. How much time it is staying in the liquid phase and how much time it is staying in gaseous phase. So that is nothing but the residence time in the hydrological cycle. How much time the water is staying in a particular phase, that is nothing but residence time. So residence time is nothing but volume of water volume of water in a phase, volume of water in a phase by average flow rate of water in that phase, average flow rate of water in that phase, in that phase. See here, what is unit of volume of water? That it is meter cube. Let the unit of volume of water is meter cube. So what is the unit of rate of flow? It is meter cube per second. So if you take the ratio of these two, you will get the unit as second. That means that is nothing but the residence time. That is nothing but the residence time. Okay, so this is nothing but residence time. We are going to use different terms in hydrology. So let us understand the important terms in hydrology. The first among those terms is catchment area. Catchment area. Catchment area. What is meant by catchment area? Or we can say it as watershed area also. Watershed and catchment area, both are synonyms. Okay. Watershed area. See here, catchment area is nothing but whenever rainfall occurs. For example, take this is a catchment. This is a catchment. Whenever rainfall occurs in this catchment, whenever rainfall occurs in this catchment, anywhere, it will be having a stream at the center of the catchment. There will be a stream. Okay. So all the rainwater, whatever be the rainwater, wherever it falls in the catchment, it will come and meet the stream here. It will come and join the stream here. Now, so this is the boundary, catchment boundary. Here also, if the stream occurs here also, anywhere on the catchment boundary also, till the end of the catchment, whatever the rainfall that comes will enter into the stream which is running into this, in this catchment. So catchment is nothing but at the location up to which whatever be the water particle which falls due to precipitation will come to the stream within the catchment. If this rainfall outside this catchment will not feed water here, it will serve another catchment. Okay, now so this is nothing but catchment area. This is nothing but catchment area. What is ridge line or ridge? What is meant by ridge or ridge line? Ridge is nothing but the topmost point of a catchment. Topmost contour line. Topmost contour line of a catchment. Topmost contour line of a catchment. So that is this is the line. This is the line which is deciding the catchment boundary, isn't it? This line is deciding the catchment boundary. So because the elevation of this line is very high, in comparison to the elevations of all other points, that is why it is behaving like a boundary. For example, if you see the cross-sectional view of this, if I see the cross-sectional view, it will be like this. So this is called ridge line. This is called ridge. It's called ridge. See, in South India, if you see the two major rivers which flow almost parallel, that is Krishna and Godavari. the two rivers which almost flows parallel. For example, this is Krishna River. This is Krishna River's ridge. So whatever the water flows, so this is the boundary of Krishna and Godavari. Let this is Krishna River or Krishna Basin. This is Godavari Basin. This is Godavari Basin. So both basins, both the catchments, catchment, basin, all are synonyms only. Watershed, catchment, basin, all are synonyms only. Here we can call this basin also. We can call this basin also catchment, or even we can call it as basin also. Now here, whenever, as I told you, ridge is the topmost point. Ridge is the topmost point. If some water falls here, just right side to the ridge, it will feed the Godavari basin catchment. If the water just falls left side to this ridge, then it will feed the Krishna basin water. So likewise, the ridge separates two different basins or catchments. That is nothing but the ridge. Now when, because of any reason, if this Krishna water is leaking into Godavari, so that means though it is falling here, because of some opening here within the soil here, so this water is leaking into the Godavari basin. Actually, this is called catchment leakage. This is called catchment leakage. This is called catchment leakage. That means this point, water here should feed, water here should feed the Krishna basin, but it is feeding the Godavari basin because of catchment leakage. So if the water which is falling in one catchment, if it is feeding other catchment, then we call it as catchment leakage. Then we call it as catchment leakage. Okay. So next terms, which are important terms, are precipitation. Precipitation. What is meant by precipitation? Precipitation is nothing but whatever the form of water which is reaching to the earth's surface from the clouds. That is nothing but precipitation. So all the forms of water, all the forms of water that reaches earth's surface like rain, snow, hail, frost, etc. So all these forms of water is nothing but precipitation. Generally, we always say that when the rainfall, when there is rain outside, we call it as actually that is the original name is precipitation. Rainfall is one form of precipitation only. It may be snowfall, it may be hail, it may be frost. All are the precipitations, but rainfall is nothing but only when there is in the form, when it is in the form of water droplets. And also there is a size range also. We will discuss the size range also in the types of precipitation. So that is the within the size range we call it as rain, but rainfall is only a subset of precipitation. Okay. Next is evaporation. Evaporation. Conversion of water into vapor. Conversion of water into vapor due to heat energy is nothing but evaporation. Conversion of water into vapor due to heat energy is nothing but evaporation. Whenever water is heated, we all know that it becomes vapor, that is nothing but evaporation. Next is interception. Interception. That means when there is vegetation, when there is vegetation present on the ground surface, when the precipitation occurs, the vegetation will obstruct the flow of the water. The vegetation obstructs the flow of the water to some extent. For example, when the precipitation is taking place on the ground, now it forms like a runoff. If there is vegetation here, if there is vegetation here, so this vegetation obstructs the flow. Okay, this vegetation is obstructs the flow. That interception, that means intercept means what? It is intercepting. It is obstructing the flow of water. That is why whatever the water which is storing because of the interception of this vegetation is nothing but interception storage or simply interception. Okay. This is nothing but the short term. It's nothing but short term retention. Nothing but short term retention of rainfall water. Rainfall water due to the obstruction of vegetation. Due to the obstruction of vegetation. Next is infiltration. I have already told you infiltration in the hydrological cycle. The movement of water, of surface water, the movement of surface water into the Earth's crust. That is soil. So the movement of surface water into the soil is nothing but infiltration. I have shown this in the hydrological cycle diagram. So now, likewise, we will discuss percolation, transpiration, all these terms once we start our course. Okay. What is meant by runoff? So all these things we can discuss, what are the different forms of precipitation and all we will discuss once we start our session. So I would like to discuss some questions which came in the previous public works department examinations. I have taken them straight away from the paper. So let us see the first question. Pick up the correct statement from the following. When the rainfall rate exceeds the infiltration capacity, the water enters the soil at full capacity rate. That means what is the first statement saying? When the rainfall rate, let the rainfall rate is the precipitation. Okay, let the rainfall rate is the infiltration. Sorry, intensity of the rainfall. Intensity of the rainfall. Let the infiltration capacity is FC. When the rainfall rate exceeds, that means I is greater than infiltration capacity. The water enters the soil at full capacity rate. This is the first statement. That means water enters soil. That means the infiltration is FC. He is saying this. When the rainfall rate is less than infiltration capacity, if it is less than infiltration capacity, then the infiltration rate is approximately equal to the rainfall rate. That means infiltration rate, F is equal to I. This is the second statement. The actual infiltration rate at any time may be equal to or less than infiltration capacity. So FP at any point of time may be equal to or less than infiltration capacity. So now this statement is correct. When the rainfall exceeds the infiltration capacity, the soil will have infiltration at full capacity rate. This is correct. When the rainfall is less than infiltration capacity, then the intensity of rainfall is equal to rainfall rate. This is also correct. And the actual infiltration rate at any point may be equal to or less than, because this is the maximum infiltration capacity. So all the infiltration capacities will be less than or equal to the maximum infiltration capacity. This is also correct. So this answer is correct. All the above is correct answer for this. So why all these options are correct, you can only understand once we discuss the topic of infiltration. Okay. So once we discuss the topic of infiltration in detail, you will understand why I have said A, B, C are correct. Next question is, the rate of rainfall for successive 10-minute period intervals for 60-minute duration storm are shown in the below figure. See here, this is 10 minute rainfall graph, rainfall hydrograph. Now here he has shown the pi index. Pi index was given as 3. So what is the runoff? See how we determine the pi index. Pi index is defined as P minus R by T. P minus R by T. This is nothing but it is the pi index is nothing but we calculate pi index from the rainfall which is causing rainfall excess by the duration. Rainfall excess by duration. See here, always we need to take the value of the precipitations above. Value of precipitations above the pi index. Value of precipitations above the pi index. Because as per the definition, rainfall excess. You need to take the rainfall excess. Where the rainfall is exceeding the pi index. So here this rainfall is not exceeding pi index. This rainfall is not exceeding pi index. So there is no rainfall excess in this two durations. And we need to calculate the duration of rainfall excess only. Duration of rainfall excess only. We need to calculate the duration of rainfall excess only. So where the rainfall excess is happening here, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So for 10 minute durations, I am having the rainfall excess. So what are the values of rainfall excess here? This is 6, this is 10, this is 8 and this is again 7. So these are the values of the rainfall. Rainfall value 6 plus 10 plus 8 plus 7 minus runoff, I don't know, by what is the duration? 1, 2, 3, 4. So duration of rainfall excess is 4 into 10. Duration of rainfall excess is 4 into 10. Okay, 4 into 10. Now here it was given in 3 centimeter per hour. Here this is minutes. 4 into 10 is minutes. I need to convert this into hours. For converting this into hours, I need to divide it with 60. So this is nothing but 4 by 6. This is nothing but 4 by 6. That means 2 by 3. This is 2 by 3. So 6 plus 10, 16, 24, 7. 24, 7 is 31. So 31, this is 31, 16, 24, 31 minus R. Pi value is 3 centimeter per hour. Whenever you are doing any solution, you need to compare the units also. 31 is centimeter, minus R is also in centimeter I will get. And this is 2 by 3 R. This is 2 by 3 R. If I bring it here, then it will become 3 centimeter per hour into 2 by 3 R. 3, 3 cancels, R cancels, is equal to 31 centimeter minus R. So R is equal to 31 minus 2 centimeter, that is 29 centimeter. That is, we are doing some mistake here. Here we are doing a small mistake. That is actually here the phi index was given per hour, right? This 3 is the value per hour. That means this 6 is also per hour. This 6 centimeter is also per hour. This 10 is also per hour. This 8 is also per hour. And 7 is also per hour. But here I am taking 10 minutes readings only. Here I am taking 10 minutes readings only. That means, so if this is the reading for 60 minutes, then what is the reading for 10 minutes? So 6 by 10. The reading of 10 minutes would be 6 by 10. Similarly, it is 10 by 10. Similarly, it is 8 by 10. Similarly, it is 7 by 10. So these are the readings of 10 minutes rainfall, 10 minute durations. So if I do this, so this one will be associated up to here. This will become 31 by 10. This will become 31 by 10 minus R. 31 by not 10, that is 6. Because it is for 60 minutes. For 60 minutes, the value of precipitation is 6 centimeter. For 1 minute, it is 6 by 60. For 10 minutes, it is 6 into 10 by 60. That means 1 by 6. Not 10 here. It is 6. I need to take it as 6. Okay. I need to take it as 6 here. Instead of 10, I need to put 6 here everywhere. Six by six, 10 by six, 8 by six, 7 by six. Similarly here, I will get 31 by six. Similarly here, I will get 31 by six, right? 31 by six. So if you solve this, so it is approximately five, right? It is approximately five. Five minus two is 3 centimeter. Five minus two is 3 centimeter. So 3 centimeter will be the runoff. 3 centimeter will be the runoff in this case. Okay. So now the last question. So the last question we are going to discuss now is this. The area enclosed by adjacent isohides of a catchment basin are shown below. See, when isohides are given, for example, if this is a catchment, these are the isohides. This is the area between the isohides. A1, A2, A3, like that. A4. If you know the precipitations here, for example, this is P1, P2, P3, P4, and P5. Then the average precipitation, average precipitation is equal to P1 plus P2 by 2 into A1 plus P2 plus P3 by 2 into A2 plus P3 plus P4 by 2 into A3 plus P4 plus P5 by 2 into A4. Like this, this is the formula by A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. So this is a formula for finding the average precipitation using isohyetal method. So now here, the average of isohyte, I need to first calculate. Here it is 45, here it is 55, here it is 65, here it is 75, here it is 85. So 45 into the area in between these two isohytes, that is 1500 plus 55 into 2500 plus 65 into 3000 plus 75 into 2000 plus 85 into 1000 by total area. So 1500 plus 2500, that means how much? 3000, 4000, 7000, 9000, 10000. This is 10,000 square kilometers. If you solve this, you will get 6,35,000. 6,35,000 by 10,000. So this is coming as 63.5 centimeter. It's coming as 63.5 centimeter. Okay. So these are the questions which I have directly taken from the paper. All these questions are being taken from the previous year, previous examination of this public works department exam only. These are the standard of the questions. These questions needs little understanding of the concepts. Okay, so it is better for you if you enroll for the course. Definitely it will add some marks to you and definitely you will get benefited. If you are weak in some concepts and if you are strong in some other concepts, so in the weak concepts definitely you will become strong and you can compete with the competitors along with you, and you can definitely achieve your goal. Okay, so that is why I suggest you to please enroll to this course, and thank you so much.